Namaste, Ambassador.
Namaste and Shalom.
Thank you. Shalom, Ambassador. I think it's a wonderful opportunity to sit down and talk about Israel's tremendous ally, India. As an Israeli, I'm curious to hear from you, how is Israel viewed by the people of India?
Well, the relationship between our two peoples goes back centuries. And as you would be aware, India is one of the few places in the world where Jews have never been persecuted. So in India, at a general level, there's a tremendous goodwill for Israelis. You're admired for your achievements in water and agriculture. You're admired for your resilience as a people. And you're admired for the way you've stood up for yourself against all odds.
Israel is celebrating 70 years of recognition by India. But the truth is that Indians and Jews have had an alliance long before that. And, you know, while we have these diplomatic relations, to me as an Israeli, it feels like India and Israel don't have a friendship of decades, but it feels like we are a family. My question is, what kind of relationship does Israel and India have? I mean, how are the two countries benefiting from this alliance?
We are each other's strategic partners, and it's a term we don't use lightly. And there are tremendous opportunities for both the countries, especially when it comes to our scientific and technological cooperation.
What are the strengths of India that can be harnessed by Israel?
One is a very deep pool of highly talented scientific and technological manpower which India has. And the second strength is the depth of Indian economy.
You know, when you first came to Israel, what was the one thing that was different, that you noticed that was different from India?
Well, I think there would be quite a few things to mention. I think to begin with, your street food is perhaps less spicy compared to Indian street food, which on the other hand, probably has a greater variety. The other thing which comes to my mind readily is the candor with which Israelis generally express themselves. The Sabras are known for their forthrightness, which can be quite refreshing at times. And in India, in our culture, we tend to tiptoe with our views.
What was the one thing that you noticed in Israel that we have in common with India?
I see tremendous creativity in the startups and the cultural scene in India, and I see it here.
Now, this is a tricky question. What should I know before coming to India?
So when you go to India for the first time, you will have very superficial impressions because you'll be hit by a sensory overload for all your senses. But the reality of India is much beyond that. You have to scratch the surface and try and go beneath it. But for that, you'll have to be patient, and you'll discover an Indianness, if I can say that, a culture which has made us so tolerant and accepting over the centuries. A visit to India can transform you at a very deep level, but you have to be patient. You have to be willing to dive beneath what seems to be apparent.
Is there a message that you would like to deliver to both Israelis and Indians who are watching this?
A lot of Indian soldiers, some of whom were Jewish Indian soldiers, fought in Israel during the two world wars and sacrificed their lives.
Here in Israel?
Yes. And one of the battles they fought was the Battle of Haifa. They liberated Haifa on September 23, 1918. There were three Indian cavalry regiments which did so. And that commemoration, that ceremony is coming up in less than 2 weeks on September 23. So whenever you have time, please do go to the Haifa Cemetery as a mark of respect to these soldiers.
You know, I just want to say, you know, looking at the flags, the flags don't look similar, but our people have a lot of things in common and similarities, which I think is just amazing. Thank you so much for the time and for being here in Israel, helping to build even, you know, closer and stronger this alliance that we already have.
Thank you. And since your new year is around the corner, so Chag Sameach, Shana Tova Umituka.